Hi there, guys. This is Megs from the Offbeat Traveler. I am doing my very first video post today. It's a beautiful March day here in Greece. The sun is shining, the breeze is out, and what a day to take a hike. Today I'm hiking from Loutraki up to Osio Patapio. It's a monastery that is built close to the peak, I guess, of the mountain here. There's a couple of gorgeous trails to come up the front side of the mountain. Today I did the front side. I've done the back side of the mountain as well from a town called Pisia. But today, right from Loutraki, I caught the path, which is the old road to Berahora. Apparently before the main road was built from Loutraki to Berahora and Blue Lake and et cetera, et cetera. Locals use this road to go from Berahora and to Loutraki, vice versa. It is a gorgeous trail. You have, you know, the sea on one side, you have the mountains on the other. And at the end, you get this beautiful spiritual experience. The nuns are wonderful. They offer you some coffee, bread, sweets. There is a fountain. You can refill your water. It does take a couple hours to hike up the mountain, so I do suggest you bring water, snacks. I brought a couple oranges. It is March. They're in season. Good way to just boost some energy for the way back down. I am going to try a different route on the way back down. I can see another road. Some people said it's a little bit faster. I'll let you know. Now, I did get super excited about doing this poster that I did forget to take a couple shots at the beginning of the trail and add it to the video. What I'll actually do is take some photos, because it isn't quite obvious where it starts. I'll take a couple photos, I'll add it to the post. You can catch it on the offbeattraveler.com, as well things to do in Loutraki. But I do suggest this. It's definitely doable. I always say in Greece, you definitely need a car to do a lot of the really cool and interesting things, because it's not easily accessible. Guys, this is one of the things that right from Loutraki, you can hike up the mountain. You don't need a car. If you're staying in Loutraki and you feel like getting a little hike in and enjoy just some beautiful nature, visit the monastery, which is very unique. The relics of St. Patapios is held here. You can go in and see. It's just wonderful. Go for it. Anyways, I'll add all the information you need on my post. Thank you for watching. Okay, so I just got down the mountain. And I have to tell you, the second path was definitely much quicker. It was only about an hour to come down the mountain. However, the path was a little bit trickier. It was a straight shot down the mountain. A lot of loose rocks. You got to be careful. So really, both paths are really great. It just depends on what you're looking for. If you're looking to have a quick 1 hour hike up a mountain that's challenging. You can definitely try that out. If you're looking for more of a leisurely stroll through the mountain that's going to take you through some paths through the trees and take a couple hours to enjoy the view, I would definitely suggest the first trail that I took this morning. Either which way, I'm going to post pictures as to where both of these trails start down on my page. As well, just to give you a heads up, if you're looking for these starts, it's on a road in Loutraki called the Periferiako, which is essentially a road that takes you up and above the city to avoid going through the city. So even if you're staying in the city and you just start heading up towards this big main road that runs above the city, you can come across both entrances to the path. Anyways, thanks again for watching. I'm gonna go enjoy the rest of my day. It's a beautiful day. It's a gorgeous beach, so I'm gonna go enjoy. Thanks again for watching. Bye.